Hello and welcome to Zoellner Arts Center. Please take a moment to silence and darken all cell phones and other electronic devices. In case of emergency, exits are located to the left and right of the orchestra and balcony and at the rear of the grand tier. Please note, food and drink, photographs, and recordings of any kind are strictly prohibited. If you need to leave during the performance, please use the rear doors to avoid disturbing other audience members and the performers. Thank you.
I attend Lincoln Elementary School. I'm in fourth grade.
I'm Anna, and I'm in fourth grade at Spring Garden Elementary School.
My name is Jordan. I am in fourth grade.
Hi, my name is Avery Pierce. I am fifth grade at Farmersville Elementary School.
Hello, my name is Alex. I am 13 years old, and I'm in eighth grade.
My name is Juliet Broski. I go to James Buchanan, and I'm in fifth grade.
My name is Sophia Cologne. I go to Marvine Elementary.
Graydon, can you tell me, what's your favorite thing about your play?
My play is Hustlers. I love you, Mom.
Julius, what is your play about?
It's about some, like, bat and robot trying to find, like, the perfect bed for the bat, and the robot's trying to help them on the way.
It's about a girl and her mom's restaurant is starting to be sold, so she competes in a cooking competition to get the money to save the restaurant.
Princess and the Warrior Clothes is about a princess who she doesn't really feel right in her position. She wants to go out, be a warrior like her brothers, but her mom is like keeping her in this isolated box.
The play is about two sisters who have to fight a dragon.
It is about like a bully that got in trouble by his family because he decided to bully somebody.
What inspired you to write your play, The Secret of Klaus?
Probably just like the weird thoughts that go through my head, I guess.
So what inspired me to make this play was thinking about how different schools are allowed to trade lunches and like different things about their lunch. And then I thought about like the bad parts about it. And that's how I got the nightmares part of it.
Sophia, what did you like about YPL?
I really liked when we got to talk about the settings, the plots, and also especially the plays.
I liked making new friends, and I liked that I got to write my play by myself, and like they gave me a lot of creative ideas.
I actually think I could make writing a career for me and become famous for it. Like, this feels like a path for me I could continue on.
Thanks so much. Enjoy the show.
Hi everyone, I'm Mary Wright and I'm the Education Director at Touchstone Theater, and I am so happy to be here with you all tonight. Those of you at home watching via the live stream and those of you sitting here in Zoellner Arts Center. Oh, and an extra, extra special welcome to our young playwrights whose creative ideas we are about to experience at tonight's 17th Annual Young Playwrights Festival. Woo! For 17 years, the Young Playwrights Lab program has been one of Touchstone's award-winning arts education programs that we do in schools and organizations throughout the Valley and the region. And in the Young Playwrights Lab, we teach kids how to make theater the Touchstone way, which is by playfully engaging in theater games and activities that spark creative ideas. And then those ideas get developed through out-of-the-box thinking and other activities. And then eventually, finally, they get to writing. Lots and lots of writing. But it's fun, it's dynamic, it allows the kids to imagine and to create and to inspire and to be inspired. This year, we had over 130 students that participated in the Young Playwrights Lab program. Yeah. And I had the opportunity to visit every single one of the programs, and I have to tell you that I was struck, especially this year, by the students' excitement at learning new things, at their joyful abandon in their play, and especially at the incredible generosity of spirit that they showed as they listened to each other's ideas. And I thought, you know, we could learn a lot from them. Tonight, you are about to see five plays by the finalists and scenes from the five runners-up. These are 10 plays that were chosen out of over 130 plays to be performed tonight. That's pretty awesome. And these plays were chosen because they are representative of the risk-taking and the creativity and the confidence-building that happens all year long. Through the eyes of a child, you are about to see issues like bullying and abuse of power, family relationships, the need to appreciate nature, the power of friendship, and the willingness to overlook fear of the other, all portrayed by characters like fruit bats, princesses, clouds, and yes, ordinary humans too. Now, we couldn't do our Young Playwrights Lab program or this festival without a lot of help from a lot of people and without the financial support of a lot of people too. And right now, I would like you to join me in thanking Perrone Development for their continued support these last few years as our naming sponsor. We also want to recognize our producing sponsor, Zoellner Arts Center, our friends here. Yes. We also get support from the National Endowment for the Arts, from a list of sponsors and funders and donors that you will find in your programs. And we hope that you'll think about joining them for next year. Those of you at home, you can go online to touchstone.org and make a donation there. Those of you here, if you flip your program over, there's a QR code there, and you can donate right directly that way, or there'll be an opportunity at the end of the evening. Now, at Touchstone, we believe in the great act, and we love the act of creation, and we believe in the power of the collective voice. And most especially, we love to see what happens when artists are inspired by each other. And so tonight, the directors are going to be introducing the plays that they directed, inspired by the words of the playwrights whose plays they have. And the directors and the actors and the designers all brought their own creativity to play on this stage. And the combination of all of that is magic. Our first director, I'd like to introduce my friend, Emma Ackerman.
Good evening, everyone. Our first play this evening is by Anna Zilovitz of Spring Garden Elementary School. Anna is a charming and delightful young woman. I'm so excited to be directing her play. I was told by Anna's teaching artist that she's very thoughtful. She takes a lot of time and consideration into all of the details of her work, and I appreciate that. Now, for anyone who's ever written something, a play, a story, a song, you may know that coming up with a title can be a pretty tricky bit of business. So Anna, in her usual thoughtful way, thought and thought and decided the name of her play would be Perfect Paisley, after her main character. And then she thought and thought and thought some more and decided actually what she really wanted the title to be was Perfectly Perfect Paisley. And then she thought and thought and thought some more and decided that actually the title of this play was The Perfectly Perfect Not So Perfect Paisley. And really, I think that's a wonderful description of all of us in this life. I'm sure you will enjoy this play. Thank you.
I just wanted to add one more note, which is that the last time we were here at Zoellner was 3 years ago. And 3 years ago, the youngest member of the acting company that was on this stage was that very same Anna. So here she is now, a playwright.
Paisley April Miller. Her life is perfectly perfect. So perfect, her nickname is Perfect Paisley. People thought, Paisley Miller, the girl that has everything, the girl that gets everything she wants. And it was partially true. She had diamonds and puppies and jewelry. But something was missing. And all her life, Paisley thought, what is it? What's missing? This is the story about Paisley's perfect life becoming a little less perfect, then perfect again.
Hey, Mommy.
Yes, Angels?
Today, me and Harper met a new friend, and her name is Harley. Mommy?
Sorry, it's just, actually, that name sounds very familiar. I used to go to school with a girl named Harley Garcia. She and I were very good friends at one point.
Well? Whatever happened to her?
Well, we just drifted apart. She had her crew and I had my parents. Yes, Nana and Pop-Pop.
Did you have any friends your own age?
Of course I did. Well, now, back to your little friend Harley.
Oh, yeah, so she asked us if we wanted to come over and play and, well, I... Mommy, are you okay?
I'm sorry, it's just, have a seat. I'm going to get us some juice and crackers, and then I have a very important story to tell you about when I was a child.
Yay, a story!
Okay, so here goes. Once, I was a little girl, just like your age now, and I was on the playground with my friend Harley.
So Paisley, have you heard the latest update on the news? This climate change stuff is really keeping me up at night. It is crazy.
I know. I feel you, girl.
Hey, Peanut and Jelly.
I better be Jelly.
Goodbye, Jelly. Anyway, I had something I wanted to talk to you about.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Is that Daddy?
Yep, that sure is your Daddy.
Okay, proceed with the story.
There's a school talent show next week, and I was thinking we could do that dance together, you and me.
Yeah, that'd be so fun. But Paisley and me are gonna do our dance to
Dancing Feet.
Well, I don't know who to go with. Yes you do. It's me. I'm your best friend.
Well, I kind of want to do the Cotton Eye Joe.
This is your last chance. Me or that dweeb?
Well, for a matter of fact, I pick this dweeb. I mean Ryan.
Fine.
Bye.
May I comment?
Always.
So that's how you drifted apart from Harley.
Yep. Now, on with the story.
Great. I just lost my best friend, and this climate change stuff is getting really worse every millisecond.
I have something to tell you.
Hmm?
I'm moving for first grade, so you might never see me again.
Ryan, it's time to go.
What? Hey, guys. Oh, bye, guys. I'll catch you later. What's up, Frances? Francesca. Bye, Francesca. I gotta go to class anyways.
Hello, class! Today we will be learning about the Declaration of Independence!
Okie dokie!
Harley!
Paisley!
May I?
Of course.
So you're lonely?
No, of course not. I had friends.
Mm-hmm. Resume.
Okay, okay. Who can tell me who wrote the Declaration of Independence?
I can.
May I?
Mm-hmm.
Alexander Hamilton and some other dudes, too.
Just the bell.
Okay, okay! Class dismissal!
And middle school went by Ryan-less and Harley-less for Paisley.
Welcome to Forest Grove High School, puny little freshman. In Forest Grove, all your dreams will not come true and it will be miserable. And I'm here to make sure of that. So go, have a good day, or a bad one, I honestly don't care.
She's not very nice.
I am Principal Gladys, and you will call me just that. Or spend 5 weeks in detention, got it?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, ma'am?
Better.
Oh, no.
Well, she's a witch.
That witch is your Auntie Gladys.
You mean Nana's best friend?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me more.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Paisley?
Ryan?
I thought I'd never see you again.
Jinx. Double jinx.
My mom got a job in New York, but then she got fired.
Well, that's bad for your mom, but great for us.
I know.
I got this one. That's Daddy again.
Yep. Do you want to maybe get lunch? I mean, I was going to go to Cheesy Burger anyway, but I definitely wouldn't mind some company.
Sure.
It's a date.
But not like a date.
Right. I mean, not like a real date.
Mm-hmm.
Time for lunch. Let's go.
So, what have you been up to for the past? What have you been up to for the past, 8 years?
Well...
Hey, babe. Oh, and you. Who are you?
Oh, I'm Paisley, Ryan's best friend.
that's really funny, because I'm Allie, Ryan's girlfriend.
Oh, mm-hmm. Ryan, you never told me you had a girlfriend.
My bad.
Yeah, you're bad.
Oh, I'll have a dairy-free, sugar-free, fat-free, gluten-free cheeseburger.
Well, that sounds disgusting!
Allie, can I talk to you?
Of course.
I think we should break up.
Is this about the girl pineapple?
Her name is Paisley. And no, I just don't think this is working out.
Ugh, fine! Bye!
What? Plot twist!
Well, she's a brat!
We just broke up.
You did what?
We broke up.
because I realized that I like you.
Oh.
Would you maybe consider being my girlfriend? And before you say anything about Allie, she thinks we're together, but we're not really together.
Then, well, sure.
Yes.
Ew!
And Ryan Paul Talbot and Paisley April Miller lived together and never grew apart. That is the story of Paisley Miller's perfect life. Ah, but not quite. They were a happy married couple for 10 years. And then the most incredible thing in the world happened to them.
Here. So you see, girls, I had a lot of things in my life, but nothing in it was good enough until I had you and your dad.
And that is the story of Paisley Miller's perfect life.
Good evening, everyone. Hi, I am Sam Beadle, and I am delighted to share in this magical night of theater. I had the honor of directing the aptly titled The Young Playwrights by an up-and-coming comedy writer, Sophia Colon from Marvine Elementary. Her teaching, yeah, give it up, yes! Sophia, are you out there? Is Sophia out there? Yes! Hi, Sophia! Hello! I'm so excited for you to see what's about to happen. And all of you, too. I heard from your teaching artists that you had a vision right away that you wanted to write, and you said yes and started writing it right away. And I will say that my interpretation of it is a bit of a surreal meta-comedy. You want to give me a thumbs up on maybe if that was real? All right, whew, thank goodness. Simply put, this play is a backstage look at how a play might look while a play is being looked at by people who put on plays. But at its true core, it is a story about having a dream, a supportive community who can help you put on something and make it real, but above all, always staying true to yourself. Theater is, and definitely comedy, is much like life. When we say yes, the possibilities are endless. So thank you all for saying yes. Yes to being here tonight. Yes to encouraging young artists. Yes to being part of community in the Lehigh Valley. I'm a big enthusiast, if you can't tell. and it means really just the world to everyone that's in this house tonight. All right, now that you've heard enough from me, I am thrilled to present to you this campy hambone comedy. Enjoy The Young Playwrights by the one and only Sophia Colon.
I will be telling you a tale of long ago. It was a year ago, so it wasn't that long. Okay, I'll be quiet.
I have been working so hard on this play, but I can't think what the setting should be. My dream is to work at a theater or be a boss, but it'll never come true. Oh, Miss Abby Jean, any ideas?
Well, there could be two explorers, and they're in the jungle, and they're trying to find buried treasure.
Whoa, I never thought of that. Thanks, Miss Abby Jean.
No problem at all.
I'm gonna go to Teacher Sam's house to show him. Knock, knock, knock.
Come in.
Thanks. I wanted to show you my play. It took me 3 days. Do you think I should show it to a director?
Wow, that's amazing. I think you should show it to a director.
Hip, hip, hooray!
And that is when she meets me. The one and only Miss Mary! Yeah! Yeah! Too loud. Too loud. Welcome to Touchstone Theater.
Hi, I'm Miss Emma. And you?
I'm Miss Mary. Come.
I'm here to see if my play could be on stage.
Oh, why yes, but I must first read it and then I could show it to a director. Oh my. Oh, my dear, you did wonderful. Oh, my goodness, crew, get in here, assemble now, come on, crew.
Wait, you guys work here?
Yes, ever since you really wanted to make a play.
Oh, you guys didn't have to. Wait, but how did you?
Toad away.
Oh my.
Lights? Who is this?
I'm Miss Emma.
Oh, you're the one who wanted to show me your play,
yes?
Okay, but I must read it first. Only then can it become real.
Okay.
Thank you. Flip. 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 must have this on the stage!
OMG! 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 I'm gonna faint. Somebody catch me. I need a break. If someone could replace me for the day, that would be nice. Miss Emma, she would be perfect as a one-day boss. Miss Emma, I'm going away on vacation and I want you to replace me as a one-day boss.
Me? That would be great.
If you do well, you will become permanent boss. But if you do bad, you will not be the boss. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Miss Emma, we finished the stage.
Yeah. We did the jungle.
Guys, that's great. And if I do great on this one day, I will become permanent boss.
Wow.
Whoa, great. Boss? Boss, 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 boss. Boss, 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 boss.
Maroon or burgundy?
Boss. Boss, 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 boss. Ugh, boss. Boss, 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 boss. Boss. Boss, 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 boss. Boss, 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 boss.
Miss Emma?
Yes?
How did you do as a one-day boss?
Oh, crew! How did I do as a one-day boss?
She did wonderful!
Then you are the new boss!
Yay! Guys, can you believe it?
Yes!
Oh no, I just checked my watch and I'm gonna be late to the movie. Well, I guess I can't go now.
You know, all your workers think you're the worst boss ever.
What? No, that is not true.
Oh, it's absolutely true.
No, you were just trying to hurt my feelings.
Well, why don't you ask your workers? Oh, I forgot. I have a video of them saying it.
She did
bad.
What? No, that's edited. I could see it.
No. You know, I might become your new boss.
Well, I am your boss right now, and I could fire you. But I am a nice boss, so I'll give you a chance.
I wish I was the boss.
Well, you're not, so get back to work.
Fine. You are so bossy.
Is that true? Am I really that bossy?
Boss, 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 boss! Permanent boss for the day.
Oh, no. Miss Emma is boss.
She did wonderful.
We worked together for so long. You have been so nice. I thought I was doing a good job. No, stop!
Miss Emma, as our boss, she was so helpful. I would love to have her as permanent boss.
Miss Emma is so thoughtful and has
the most wonderful boss.
There's no other boss I'd rather work with than Miss Emma. Miss Emma, you're the best boss ever.
You did a fabulous job, Miss Emma. I want you to be the new boss.
Miss Emma as boss? She did wonderful.
You know what? I am going to be myself.
Hey, how you doing?
Great.
I'm gonna go home for the day.
Okay.
I would be such a better boss than you.
You're fired.
What?
Go.
It's been 1 year later.
Remember that first day that I was permanent boss?
Do you see what I mean about it being magical? And I think Deirdre should just be Miss Mary from now on. We wanted to take a moment and to acknowledge the fact that it really does take a whole lot of people to make the Young Playwrights Lab program happen. And so we're going to take a moment, and if you fall into one of the categories that I'm going to name, I'm going to ask that you either stand in the audience here or from backstage, come on out. Please hold your applause until the end, and if you want to cheer in between, raise your ribbons if you've got them. Raise your ribbons if you got them. Great. You can wave those around, and we'll cheer, and we can do silent cheer, and then at the end, we'll give everybody a round of applause. Are you ready? Okay. Here's what it takes to make a Young Playwrights Lab happen. First of all, any student who was in the Young Playwrights Lab, stand up or come on out. Any teaching artist involved in the Young Playwrights Lab program. The teaching partners. How about the district administrators? How about the school principals? How about the community school coordinators and the after-school coordinators? How about the families of the Young Playwrights? Please stand. How about anyone who has ever donated to or attended a Young Playwrights Festival? Please stand. That includes all of you. Let's give ourselves a round of applause. It takes a village. Thanks, you can go back to your seats. As you can see, it really does take a village to make this all happen. And so thank you for being part of that village. We are now ready to start seeing some of our scenes, and I'm going to invite the director out, my dear friend, the most amazing Lisa Jordan.
Thank you, Miss Mary. Good evening. Oh, all right, let's try again. Good evening. Thank you. It is my awesome privilege to get to direct a selection of scenes from our runner-up plays. Now, we handle the scenes a little differently, so the actors are all the Young Playwrights Lab teaching artists and Touchstone Company members, but what you won't see on stage is any design elements. So no costumes, no props, no sound cues. So what that means is all of you have to use your imagination just like our playwrights did when they were dreaming up their scripts. You ready for the challenge? Yeah? All right, awesome. Our first scene is The Bat Story by Julius Avila. He's from Dunnigan Elementary School, and I learned from Julius's teaching artist that Julius is quite funny and enjoys corny jokes. You may get a taste of some of those later on in his script. I also learned that Julius loved writing and always wanted more time to work on his script. We're gonna share the first, nope, I lied. We're gonna share the second scene where we meet a bat who's experiencing maybe a familiar plight to many of us. The bat just needs a good night's sleep. Please enjoy The Bat Story by Julius. Scene two, 5 long months later. They both reach an alleyway where they find a raccoon.
Raccoon!
Do you have the map like you said?
Sure.
Distant chatter.
That perfect bed is mine!
Scene three, one short week later, at their camp.
I actually never camped before.
Don't worry.
Pulls out a lemon.
Ha, ha, nice. Do you got any more?
Yes, how about this? Why was the lemon so queasy?
Why?
Because it was feeling sour.
Ha, 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 ha.
They laugh themselves to sleep. Scene four, the next day. So a mech, for people that don't know, like me, and had to look it up, is a giant, like, mechanical robot that then a human gets into and can control. Okay. Like that, over there.
Try it if you want, but the bed is mine.
The mech pushes up the rocks against the roof.
Oh, God. Oh, no.
The cave starts to rumble. Robot uses his powers to track where the rocks are going to fall. He snatches fruit bat and holds up the bed with one hand.
Thank you, but why did you save me?
Because even if you were our enemy, we couldn't let you get crushed by those rocks.
We hope that you learned your lesson. Sometimes the thing you want the most is the one thing you cannot get.
I promise I won't ever fight over the thing that I want most.
To be continued. Our next scene is from Trying to Find a Bike by Raiden Reyes from Casa Guadalupe Center. Go ahead, I heard some applause starting. Yeah. Raiden's teaching artist shared that Raiden enjoys making clay art and really loves to draw. In fact, some of his drawings inspired his script. I also learned that Raiden knew his characters, he wanted them to be things and not people. So he set out with that in mind, and I really enjoy the character descriptions. So I'll share two of them with you. Book, a book who likes to read books in the library, and Bubble, a bubble who has a job. Tonight we'll share the first scene of Raiden's play. Please enjoy Trying to Find a Bike by Raiden Reyes. Scene one, Book is on the street looking for his bike. He's putting up posters.
Where's my bike? Oh, it must be on the train.
Hi, Book. I'm waiting for the train to come.
Have you seen my bike?
Yes, I have seen your bike. It's on the train tracks.
Sorry, nobody is allowed on the tracks. Listen to me.
They try to get the bicycle with a rope. The rope breaks.
Didn't work. We need tape! I have tape.
They try to use tape. But it doesn't work. Everybody runs! He runs. Grabs the bike. They get out of the way just in time. To be continued. All right, our next scene is from Dragon Gates by Avery Pierce of Farmersville Elementary School. Now, a little birdie told me that today is Avery's birthday, so can we say happy birthday, Avery, on the count of three? Yes, we can. One, two, three.
Happy birthday, Avery!
Awesome. Avery's teaching artist shared that she is quite clever and has a dry sense of humor. One of the qualities that I really enjoyed reading her script is the stage directions. They're such an entertaining addition that you'll get to hear some of them through the narration tonight. We're going to start in the action-packed second scene, which starts in a castle on a cloud. Please enjoy Dragon Gates by Avery Pierce.
Inside the castle before.
She steps forward, but she stumbles and falls. Woo! She then lands on a cloud.
Wow. Oh, it's so fluffy. I don't need to be thinking about that right now. I've got more important things to worry about. Like, how am I going to get beyond the castle range? That huge dragon is in my way of the gates trying to get out, and... Wait!
The dragon has made the gates budge a bit, and they are out of place.
No! This is bad! Very, very bad!
The dragon pushes again, and the gate is close to breaking. Sadie enters through the castle doors just as the dragon breaks the gate.
Oh, my Lord! Cecily! Help!
Sadie runs down the stairs and onto the cloud. She runs to Cecily and gives her a metallic sword made with real gold. Dragon scratches at Sadie and Cecily as they roll away. Cecily to the right, Sadie to the left. The dragon moves forward and tries to bite Sadie. He also turns and flaps his wings. At the time when the dragon's wings are open, Cecily takes her sword and she cuts through the dragon's wing. The dragon yelps in pain. The dragon then leaps toward them. At that exact moment, Sadie takes her hand and knocks the dragon out. The dragon falls and doesn't get back up.
That was close. Oh, at least he isn't dead. Murder is bad. You're right. Murder is bad.
To be continued.
So I'm going to ask you to continue to use your imaginations, and I'd like you to imagine that I'm about 6'2", and my name is Bill George. Bill's the director of the next play, and unfortunately, he could not suddenly be here tonight, and so he asked me to fill in for him, and he sent me what he wanted to say. Hi, my name is Bill George. I'm one of Touchstone's founders and an ensemble member here at Touchstone, and I had the pleasure of directing Juliet Broski's Clouds Secrets that she wrote at Buchanan Elementary. Shortly after it was announced that Juliet's play was going to be produced, I got a letter from her family that said that when Juliet was explaining her play to them over dinner, they were flabbergasted as to how meaningfully intense it was and that she is so compassionate. They told me that ever since she was just a little bein', that back in preschool, she was called the peacemaker. So thank you, Juliet, O thou peacemaker, for this play. Thank you for its intensity, but also its sweet humor. Clouds Secrets by Juliet Broski.
Some people may say clouds are just boring gases, but I know the truth. Oh, you want me to tell you? Well, let me tell you a story first. There was once a place, an empire, if you will. Many great beings lived there.
Ah, the harvest is fresh. Again. Oh, it's okay, Gojo.
Gojo is kind of like what you would call a cat and a frog mixed together.
Hey, what's that behind that tree?
Sandra ran home. She was terrified. She told her parents, but they didn't believe her. She cried. It had just seeped in how scary that was. She eventually just believed her parents, who told her she had imagined it. A few days later, Billy, Tello, and Ava were going to watch the sunset. Tello and Ava walked up to the sunset. Billy was sad, since his mother had just passed away. While his friends watched the sunset, Billy stared blankly at the trees. That's when he saw it. Billy had just seen the shadow. Billy, the next day, had a bad thought. Billy, since that day, would often look for the shadow and never see it. Many other people spotted the shadow, and Billy would always ask them for leads as to where to find it. but nobody knew. Billy believed it was all his fault for screaming. He thought he'd never see her again. A full year passed. Nobody did anything about the shadow, but give it silly names like Smokey, or Spook, or Old Creep. If only they'd taken it more seriously, because suddenly... It is now the harvest fest.
Step right up, get your harvest here, fresh harvest. You look like a smart man, fresh harvest. Hello, everybody. Welcome to my harvest station, the freshest harvest in all the land, on sale. Sale. S-A-I-L. Get it? It was a typo. Would you like some harvest? We got white. We got off-white. Oh, my gosh. What is that?
Do you see what I see? Mom, is that you? Mom?
I am not your mother, silly being.
It talked.
I am your creator. All this time, I've been watching this story. But sadly, this is the end. I've made you since the beginning, this town, this harvest, all that you love. But sadly, the story is over now. Look down.
We are clouds? Mom, is that you?
Yes, honey. It's me.
Come on, honey, let's go to the park.
Okay, Dada. Oh. Hey, Dad, look at the clouds. They look like they're hugging. Whoa, and that looks like a cat, or maybe a frog.
Come on, let's go play before it gets dark.
Okay.
Next time you see a creature or an object or really anything in the clouds, remember this interesting empire.
Are we on? Yes, hello. Welcome to the festival. My name is Kate Scuffle Miller, and I have been lucky enough to direct a wonderful play called The Bad Bully by one of our younger playwrights, Jordan Colon, who is a fourth grader at Fountain Hill Elementary School. Jordan, are you in the house? Yes. When our play opens, we meet Dominic and his younger brother, Nick. Now, Dominic's days are filled with what fills most teenagers' days, family, friends, school, music, and sadly, bullying and violence. But when Jordan came and joined us at our rehearsal and chatted with us, he shared that what was really important to him in telling this story and in writing this play was telling a story that held space for our ability to change, grow, learn, and make better, kinder choices. So with no further ado, we are so happy to share that story with you tonight. The Bad Bully by Jordan Colon.
Don't know, don't care.
What?
Nothing.
Okay.
Can you stop annoying me, though?
Can you play trucks with me, please?
Oh, my God. Can you be quiet?
Please, Mom and Dad will not let Logan over.
No! Nick! Hayden!
Dom! What?
A truck? Why do you have this?
My brother Logan is so annoying.
Same! But his name is different.
Yesterday, he hit me with his toy truck and acted like he was sorry, but he was not. But he is three.
What are you guys talking about?
Nothing much.
We're talking about our little brothers.
Oh, my brother is stronger than you and your brother.
Why did you do that?
Because I can. What are you going to do about it?
Well, you know, there are teachers around us, right?
Don't tell the teacher. Let's just leave.
Get ready for school. Why do you have a black eye?
Because Dominic hit me.
Dominic, you are grounded for an entire week. Why do you have a bruise on your face?
Because my bully, Jake, hit me.
Wait, you know Jake? He hit you? Me and Jake's mom are friends. I'm gonna call Jake's mom and speak to her about this.
What is going on here? What happened to my kids?
Thank you.
Why did you hit Dominic at school today?
No, I didn't. I never hit him. He's telling a lie to your face.
So if I ask him right now, that will be the truth.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so did Jake...
Okay, Mom, I did.
I didn't even really call. I just acted like it to see if I could get the truth out of you, and it seems like I did. Now, for lying to me in my face, you are grounded for 3 months. Never, ever hit anybody at school again, or you're gonna be grounded for a year and get that phone taken away.
But...
No buts. Give me your phone and go to your room. You're grounded. Now.
Nick, now I see how it feels to get bullied. I'm sorry for ever hitting you, and I learned to treat others how I like to be treated.
It's okay. I mean, we're family after all, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Look how that changed.
We're back with our final two scenes of the evening. The first one, The Princess in the Warrior Clothes by Mariah Marie Randolph of Lincoln Elementary. Mariah's teaching artist shared that she knew exactly what she wanted to write about. And after maybe a little bit of disbelief that she could write her own play, Mariah had a million ideas. Her play is a whopping 12 scenes across various locations like a mysterious forest, princess warrior camp, and a ballroom. We'll share the first two scenes of Mariah's play. Please enjoy Princess in the Warrior Clothes by Mariah Marie Randolph.
Like you, Juan.
You know, sis, being a warrior is dangerous. And you're the next queen. We have to protect you.
I just don't like being cooped up in this castle. I feel like such a burden to you guys.
You're not a burden. You're just misunderstood.
I just wish that Mom knew that I don't like girly stuff, and I like to look at swords and armor and...
Hey, sis! Oh. You okay, sis?
Hey, stop copying me!
Warrior.
What?
Well, no, I know it's dangerous.
Nope, nope, nope,
not be a warrior.
But
I do not want to hear any more excuses. Goodbye. Door slams.
I just wish she would understand.
Diana, are you okay? I heard your mom yelling.
Well, I just told her I wanted to be a warrior.
Oh, yeah. I thought she might react like that.
I just wish that she understood like you do.
You know, your mom used to be a warrior.
No way that my mother used to be a warrior!
I'm serious.
No, I don't believe you.
You know, you could come with me to the armor shop, and I could prove that your mom was a warrior. She used to go there all the time.
Okay, but I'm gonna prove to you that there is no way that my mom was a warrior.
Our final scene of the evening is from School Lunch Trading Nightmares by Alexander Cook of Nitchman Middle School. I learned from Alex's teaching artist that he is quite funny and that Alex and another playwright in class were very much partners in comedy crime. Alex's play, in many ways, is a tale as old as time. We all reminisced during rehearsal about the things that we traded in the school lunchroom. Snacks, of course, but also garbage pail kids, pogs, snap bracelets. Jogging any memories for people? tonight, you'll get in on the trading action. We'll share a couple of scenes towards the beginning of Alex's play. Please enjoy School Lunch Trading Nightmares by Alexander.
Also, we're completely smashing through the fourth wall.
But we wanted to tell you guys that to us, trading is very important, and we love it so much.
When trading first came into our lives, we were delighted, because if we could not trade, we could lose our friendships, because we would be jealous of each other's lunches.
Yeah, we love the fact we don't have to be jealous anymore, because we have the gift of giving food for food.
Okay, all right. I think we're done with the fourth wall now.
Yeah, you're right.
Back to the show!
All right, I'll start us off with one bag of Talky.
I will give you a chocolate milk if you throw in a second bag.
Oh, that's kind of a steal. I'll give you a small bag of Cheddar Puffs.
Deal!
Hey, Alex, give me one chocolate milk for one bag of fruit roll-ups and a bag of Cheddos.
Oh, heck yeah, deal!
All right. I'll give you one bag of Talkies for two fruit roll-ups and a pack of loopy snacks.
Fine.
Yeah. All right, I have one bag of Takis and one bag of Cheddos.
Oh, give me a slice of that action.
Hey, Josh, do you really have that salt and vinegar chips?
Yeah, I do. You want it?
Yeah, one bag of Takis for it.
Sure.
Before I get sick, let's eat.
Yeah! Good evening, everyone. My name is Ashley Weller, and I am incredibly excited to bring the final play for the evening, Star is Who You Are, by Emmy Dandridge from Governor Wolf Elementary. So about 2 weeks ago, we had Emmy in our rehearsal, and we were so excited and nervous, because the playwright, whew. And so we quickly found out that she loves theater and dance and cooking, while baking, and especially cupcakes, and I agree, I love cupcakes. So, and we were so thankful that she was in the room with us, because the cast was having a heated debate about how to pronounce the sister's name. And so she cleared that up for us, and she had a great time, and the cast and I were so thankful that she got to spend the afternoon with us. So without further ado, Star is Who You Are.
is unbelievable.
I know, she really has a nerve to give you detention for a week.
I mean, all I did was ignore her for the whole class and go on my phone.
Well, that might have not been the best choice.
Yeah, I guess I should have made better choices.
Okay, it's gonna be fine. Okay, hey, Mom. By the way, I kinda got detention.
No. Okay, we'll see you at 7 then. Bye-bye.
I got detention. Well, don't come then. Okay, I got detention. Well, sort of for a week. Well. Hey, Mom.
I have something to tell you.
Okay, what is it?
Wait, what? And how do you expect me not to get mad, Star? You are definitely grounded until I say.
I figured you would say something like that.
All right, now come help me cook.
Yes, ma'am.
Star, I need to talk to you for a second.
What happened?
Star, I need to talk to you for a second.
What happened?
I know this may be hard to believe, but the real estate company threatened to sell the restaurant.
What? They can't do that?
Honey, that's not in our control. They said that if we don't make $50,000 by the end of the month, they're going to sell the restaurant. And let's face it, we can't make that much money even if we tried.
Hold on. We're not going to give up that easily. Eventually, we will figure something out.
I have a big problem. Some big real estate company threatened to sell our restaurant.
God, that's terrible.
Oops, hold on. Let me check this real quick.
Whoa! There's a partner cooking competition, and the prize is $100,000!
Wow! You should enter it! Then, if you win, you can save your mom's restaurant.
I don't know. It says here that a partner has to be 14 or up.
That's perfect! You can get your sister Mika. I'm sure she wouldn't mind.
That's true, but she probably wouldn't say yes so easily. There probably would be a catch.
So what? Would you rather save your mom's restaurant or not?
Good point. All right, I'll ask my mom. If she says yes, I'll ask Mika.
Sounds like a plan.
$100,000, that's great. Oh my God, we could totally do this. Mom, big news.
Well, what is it?
There's a partner cooking competition and the prize is $100,000.
Oh my goodness, that's enough money to save the restaurant. And then we would have an extra $50,000 left over.
Exactly. So I was thinking, since my partner has to be 14 or up, I would ask Mika.
That's a great idea. She's in her room now, so maybe you can ask her.
But remember to knock. So, I have a favor to ask you.
Okay, what is it?
So there's a partner cooking competition, and the prize is $100,000, which could save our restaurant.
Awesome! But what's the favor part?
Well, you see, one partner has to be 14 or up. So, would you be my partner?
Oh.
course! Anything to save Mom's restaurant.
Oh, I thought there would be a catch.
Oh, I guess not. I'm only focused on saving Mom's restaurant.
Tomorrow's the day of the competition. We have to practice!
Oh. All right.
Come on.
Let's get started.
Bye, Mom.
Come on.
Bye, girls. Burger and cheese, and then the bacon.
Okay.
Thanks, Mika. You're awesome.
Oh, you're welcome. Now let's get you ready for bed. We have a big day tomorrow.
Good idea. Night, Mom.
Night, Mom. Yep.
Love you, too. Mom, I'll see you when we get home.
Bye, girls.
Good luck. Wait a minute. Those people look a little familiar.
Is that who I think it is?
That's Mrs. Jenkins!
No way. Oh, and there's another girl with her. Oh, who could that be?
That's Bethany. She's the meanest girl in school. She's Mrs. Jenkins' daughter. What are you guys doing here?
Oh, I heard you and Nia talking about the competition, so I told my mom, so we entered.
Why are you so nosy?
Don't talk to my daughter like that, or I'll give you even more detention.
Whatever. Oh, and tell your mom sorry about the competition, because we will win.
We'll see about that.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
Bethlehem's greatest cooking show. If you like to cook, it's the place to go.
You can make pizza.
Or biscuits.
Or chocolate souffle.
And you even win $100K.
Oh.
Oh.
Ba-da-ba-da. Thank you all for coming to the competition.
Each of you will have 1 hour to make your own spin.
On the classic food, the cheeseburger.
Good luck!
Your time starts!
Now!
Okay, I'll get the bacon part ready and you get the burger part.
Sounds good.
You guys stink. You're obviously gonna win.
How about more cooking and less talking?
Whatever.
Do you think I should put bacon inside the burger?
Yeah. Mm. Don't worry, just relax. We're doing great.
Okay.
Nervous we're gonna beat you?
Nope. Not at all.
Hi, Team One. What are your names?
My name is Star.
And I'm Mika.
Nice to meet you, Star. Mika, what do you have for us today?
We have a cheesy bacon cheeseburger.
Sounds delicious. Let's dig in. Now, what are your names?
My name's Bethany.
And my name's Maria Jenkins, but you can call me Mrs. Jenkins.
Nice to meet the both of you.
So, tell me, what have you prepared for us today?
A vegan vegetable burger.
Okay, let's try.
It's okay. It's just right here.
Thank you very much. Well, that's interesting. It should be very hard to decide.
What? Yeah. We have made our decision.
The winner of the competition
and the $100,000 is
Star and Mika!
What?
Congratulations. Great work.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congrats, I guess.
Oh, thanks.
Mom, don't congratulate them.
Excuse me? Who do you think you are? You don't talk to your mother like that.
Mom, you're embarrassing me.
I don't care. And you can join me in detention now next week. Go. Oh, and by the way, Star, I'm sorry, but what you did is still wrong. But I'm narrowing your detention down to just one day.
Thank you, Mrs. Jenkins.
You're welcome. You deserve it.
Oh, this is so unfair! I'm going to the car!
That was really fun.
You're welcome. Now let's go tell Mom.
Mom!
We won the competition!
Oh my goodness, you did it! You both saved the restaurant!
You're welcome.
You deserve it.
Oh, I love you guys.
Mia! Mia!
I won the competition!
What? That's awesome! Thanks for always supporting me.
You're welcome.
The restaurant is saved, my detention is done, and Bethany got what she deserved. I have nothing else I need to say except Star is who I am!
Thank you all so much, so very, very much. Isn't it
pretty amazing what kids can do, huh? In a moment, actually right now, if you are a festival playwright, I mean, now is the moment we're gonna ask you to head over to these stairs. So you can start heading over there. And I wanna let you know that every year when we start the new year of Young Playwrights Lab, I am always so humbled and so impressed by all of the playwrights because they come in the first day not having a clue sometimes what to expect, certainly not thinking they can write a page, let alone a play. And over the course of the sessions, they discover that they have a voice and that their voice matters. And so it is just, it is such a delight to watch that evolution happen. And so we wanted to take a moment to recognize our festival playwrights. So would you come on up and say your name? And we have some certificates and roses for them.
I'm Anna Zilovitz.
I'm Julia Sevilla.
I'm Mariah Randolph.
I'm Jordan Cologne.
I'm Juliet Broski.
I'm Avery Pierce.
And I'm Raiden Reyes Anakin.
I'm Sophia Cologne.
I'm Emmy Dandridge.
I'm Alexander Cook.
I'm Naviah Wade.
In fact, I'm going to ask everyone who was involved in the Young Playwrights Lab to come on up on this stage, because they are all stars. And so tonight, we hope that you will join us as we prepare to launch this program all over again. And if you are willing to consider making a donation, please do it at the Touchstone website using the QR code, or there'll be one of the cast members outside the doors holding a red heart, and you can put your donations in there. We couldn't do it without you. We couldn't do it without all the actors, and we certainly could not do it without all of these playwrights. Thank you. Good night.